Jackery is possibly one of the most recognized names in the power station game. They're one of the OG brands that started making small little camping units and slowly evolved over time. But in recent years, competition has ramped up a lot. And with the release of the Jackery 5000, we wanted to know, is Jackery still here to compete, or are they just trying their best not to get left behind? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Today we're looking at this unit that perfectly fills the hole between the F3800 and the Delta Pro Ultra. It's similar in size, has a very similar footprint to the F3800, yet it has a bigger battery and a bigger inverter, and it's only got about 1000 watt hours of battery less than the Delta Pro Ultra, but it comes in at about $1,500 less. And at this point, we've had our hands on this thing here at the lab for a little while now. We've run it through a bunch of testing and real life scenarios, and we feel like we are ready to give you guys our honest opinions on the Jackery Explorer 5000 plus. As always, if at any point during this video you've heard enough, there's links and any discount codes that we can get out of Jackery in the description down below, as well as links to this month's giveaway. But before we get into our opinions and our experience with this guy, we're going to hit you guys with a super quick spec teardown in case you're not already familiar with the Jackery 5000 plus. So first up, this thing does pass the tiny baby lift test, barely. It comes in at 134 pounds, so he is a pound for pound matchup with this thing. It also passes the Flexispot lift test. So thank you to Flexispot for sponsoring today's video. As you guys know, here at the lab, we would never point you in the direction of something that we don't actually like. We've been using these E7 standing desks for almost a year now, and honestly, they put the standing desks we had when we first started working together to shame. Sitting at your desk all day isn't necessarily the best for you, especially if you have a bad back like Tiny Baby does from all the lift tests. And that's why we love this E7 standing desk from Flexispot. This desk is built to last. It's made with automotive grade steel and it can support up to 540 pounds. It has a massive range of height. If you ever want to take a break from standing, you can easily lower the desk to the lower position by pressing the little dude sitting down. And the same goes the other way around. Press your little dude standing up and you can customize exactly where you want this thing to go up to and down to. And one of the best parts about this specific standing desk is it's actually super affordable compared to all the other desks on the market. Most other good quality standing desks are over $1,000. The standing desks that we had that we thought were good quality before we got these ones were almost the same price as this, but the quality of these ones just puts those to shame. Because right now you can actually get this desk for $549. Plus, if you use the code on the screen right now, you guys can save an additional $50 off your order, making this thing only 500 bucks. These desks are backed by a free 30-day return. If you don't like it, send it back. And they got a 15-year warranty on these, which is longer than most of our cars. So you can try this thing risk-free for 30 days. And if you like it, you're covered for probably longer than you're gonna have the desk. Anyways, thanks to Flexispot for sponsoring today's video. Let's get back to the Jackery 5000 Plus.
So passing the tiny baby lift test, it's a 5,040 watt hour battery bank with a 7,200 watt inverter. This unit does 120 and 240 volts directly out of the unit. In terms of getting power into this thing, it advertises that it fully charges in less time than a movie. I don't know what that's supposed to mean, because if you plug it into a regular 120 volt wall outlet, it charges in over 3 hours. It was about 3 hours and 20 minutes in our experience.
Hey, it's quicker than Avatar.
It's a long ass movie though.
Quicker than Avatar.
It is. It's got an 1800 watt AC input from the house. It's also got a 4000 watt solar input, which is really impressive compared to the battery size. When it comes to ports on this guy, on this side right here, you have an expansion battery port. You have your L14 twist lock generator port. You also have a 50 amp plug. The 50 amp plug only has a 30 amp service to it, hence the 7200 watt inverter. Still got a 50 amp plug on the side here. You have a total of 420 volt house outlets on the front. You have two USB-A's, two USB-C's, and a 12 volt car socket. And then under this really, really dumb little door on the other side, you have a low voltage solar input and a high voltage solar input. And when it comes to the rest of the build, it's honestly pretty nice. It's got the caster wheels on the front, you got your wheelie wheels on the back, you got your suitcase handle that slides out. This suitcase handle is probably the most solid feeling one that we've had on any power station yet. Usually they got a lot of play and they feel really loose. This one actually feels really good. It's got your two little handles on the side so you can easily lift it. It's got a handle underneath so that you can grab it and do like a team lift. The screen is nice. It's a regular classic Jackery screen, and the app works well. There's nothing crazy you can do in there. You can set time of use so you can peak shave with it. You can change a couple settings in there, but it's a pretty solid app overall. And the price of this guy is about $3,500, although right now at the time of this video, it's on sale for $3,000, which at that point is a really good deal.
When it comes to things that we like about the Jackery Explorer 5000 Plus, the first one's gonna have to be the design. In our opinion, they nailed it. Like, the Anker F3800 design is great, and this is very, very close to that. Like we mentioned in the teardown, it's got your wheels everywhere, it's got the handle underneath. Overall, it's just a really good design. It's easy to move around. It's just a compact, good-looking unit that kind of just feels nice in the room it's in. It's not weird-looking or anything like that. We just think they nailed the design. We also like that it retains a 12-volt car socket on a bigger unit like this. A lot of bigger units start to throw those away, which, in this case, if you were using this for some sort of camping, in your trailer, RV, or whatever, even if you just have a power outage that you're trying to last through, a 12 volt fridge, if you get power outages frequently, is a great way to save power because it doesn't use the inversion process, whatever. Plug a little 12 volt fridge in there, let it rip while your power's out, and this will last you so much longer than a full size fridge. Good job to Jackery for keeping 12 volt port. We also like that the solar input is pretty high. Right here, we have your high PV input. 4,000 watts is really good compared to the battery size. That'll fully charge this thing in under 2 hours. And if you scale it up to like the full 20 whatever kilowatt hour system you can get, you should be able to charge it up in like a day of sun, which is pretty cool. That's somewhere where when you compare it to something like the F3800, it's still, even with the updated version, feels like it's falling a little bit short when it comes to what you can input with solar. The voltage range and everything on here is fine. It works well with whatever most panels that you have. Great job. Jackery also released a smart transfer switch, which is pretty cool. We've seen this from companies like EcoFlow and Anker with the home power panel or the smart home panel. Jackery's is kind of cool because it's basically a sub panel. Like, the breakers and everything are right inside of that. You can plug 2 5000 pluses into it, run multiple expansion batteries. You basically can use that as a sub panel, which allows you to peak shave with this. You can charge it through that panel at 240 volts and then put 240 volts into the panel. But it also allows for just uninterrupted backup when the power goes out. These units, however many you have plugged in, will instantly power whatever's on your sub panel, and you won't lose activity within your home on whatever's there. So that's a really cool feature. I like the design of theirs. It seems pretty clean. I like that it just is like a simple little thing. The only thing we don't like with it is that there's no pre-drilled holes anywhere. You got to drill your own holes wherever you want your cables running out of. But aside from that, it actually feels like a pretty decent unit. And it also performed really well in all of our testing. It advertises a 14,000 watt surge. We didn't see that. Our air conditioner is about 10,000 watts surge to get it running. After that, it only runs about 3,000 watts to continuously run. This couldn't start that, but it could run close to that for quite a while, which was weird. We ran like a 9,500 watt load for like 20 seconds. We ran an 8,000 watt load for like 30 seconds, which is cool. It means if you're surging, I would say under 10,000, it has the balls to get those things going. It won't just surge real quick and shut off. It actually has it in it to keep carrying those loads out for a minute to try to get whatever you're doing running. But the 1400 number was a little shy. Otherwise, all of our testing went really well. The solar input is great. Idle consumption is high. It's a 240 volt unit, so it's like 58 watts per hour just idling. It'll run like 3.5 days if you just turn on the AC plugs and just let them go. Still better than something like the F3800 was like 80 watts or something like that. So when you compare them, not terrible. The UPS function works great. If you have a load running and the power goes out, it'll keep that load running. You won't even notice it happened. And honestly, it's very quiet when it runs. I'm not gonna say it's dead silent. You can hear it running, but like, not really. When you're running this thing at almost full tilt, it really doesn't make very much noise at all. So overall, great job with the performance of this. Jackery actually did a pretty good job. We were impressed. We didn't think it would be that good in the testing. And the last two things that we like about this unit is, one, they have a calculator on their website that actually works. A lot of companies, we've been saying this since the beginning of the channel, you go on EcoFlow's site, it'll say, oh, this unit will run your house for 30 years. And it's like, no, it probably will only last 3 hours. Like, they just over-exaggerate everything. The calculator on their website takes into account idle consumption. So if you say it has a 5,000 watt hour battery, if you say I want to run a 5,000 watt load, it says it'll run it for like 0.8 hours. It doesn't say it'll run it for a full hour because it knows it won't, which is cool. You can actually do accurate math with that. So really good job to Jackery for keeping that one in line with what it should be. And the last thing that we like with this one is that the price is just right. Like, right now, it's actually the price of the F3800, but even at full price, it's like $200 more than the F3800 Plus. It's got a bigger battery and a bigger inverter, and it performs really well. And compared to the Delta Pro Ultra, it's got the same size inverter with a 1,000 watt hours less of battery, and it's $1,500 cheaper. This just fits the market really well, and it's honestly just a good unit. When it comes to things that we don't necessarily love about the Jackery, the first one is gonna be this 50 amp plug on the side.
I get why that's there. A lot of high voltage transfer switches use a 50 amp plug. Like we have one that plugs into this, plugs into a 50 amp transfer switch so you can run a big amount of power through it. This unit though isn't rated to do the 12,500 watts of a true 50 amp. So you actually only get 30 amps of service through there. In our opinion, a 30 amp plug would have been better on there. That means you could put this directly inside of like an RV or a trailer or something like that, plug right into it and you're good to go. I think that this would be more used in a camping situation, like an RV, a trailer, something like that. And it still has the L14 generator plug, so you could still use that to go to your transfer switch and then use the 30 amp for your trailer. In this case, there's two different options for how to get it into a transfer switch, but there's no option for your trailer. This is a lesson that Anker recently learned when they released the F3800 Plus. They switched from a 50 amp back to a 30 amp because they realized that's what the people want. Another thing is that this side door right here, with the solar inputs, it only opens that high, which is annoying because you can see right now with it on the table, it's only this high off the ground. So when this thing's actually on the ground and you're trying to get in there and do stuff, you have to be almost on your hands and knees to see underneath that door. It doesn't open fully up, which is extra annoying because it's got MC4 connectors for your solar panels. So you gotta be like laying down like you're gonna do an oil change on your truck to get under there to unclip the MC4 connections. Not a fan. Another thing that we find a little weird is that it's a cool and not cool thing. They have the handle underneath. This is something we see on the Anker F3800 as well. Little fold-up handle under that unit. This unit has a handle, so you could team lift it or you could like pick it up sideways to kind of get it up some stairs or whatever. But it's weird because the handle is on the side. So to grab it, you have to lay it down on like one of the clean faces of the unit. Whereas there's actually bump stops on the back. If the handle came out of the front, you could easily just pick it up, lay it on the bump stops. In this case, you have to lay it down on like the round part of the unit. I don't know, I just feel like someone's gonna break it like slamming it down a little bit. It's cool that there's a handle there, I just feel like the placement's very awkward. There's also no light on this unit. Jackery was one of the only companies that was consistently putting lights on their units. Where's the light? We all want lights. Give us the lights. And the last one is that as of right now, there is no way to charge this thing with 240 unless you have the smart transfer switch, which is a great option, but something like the Delta Pro Ultra has a generator cable, F3800 has a generator cable. This guy, you can't charge it with 240 right now, which means that you can't peak shave with it right out of the box unless you're just running things off the front plugs. You can't charge with 120 and disperse 240 at the same time. So if you're trying to actually peak shave with a unit, you need to invest a little bit more, get a transfer switch or get something going like that. Look, at the end of the day, Jackery, you honestly did a good job with this thing. We're pretty impressed with Jackery's first like big size unit. Let us know what you guys think. As always, there is links to this month's giveaway in the description down below, so make sure you don't miss that. Otherwise, that is all we got for you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. We will catch you in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.